Alright, before we get started, I just want to go ahead and show you a quick look at the deck that I'm using to farm at level 30 Bakura. And I'll have a detailed, discussion on it at the end of the video. So if you want a detailed discussion, just go ahead and go to the end of the video and you'll be able to see it. So this is just a quick look at it, because I did forget to add it at the very beginning, so here it is. There it is. Take a screenshot or screen cap it, or I don't know what you want to do. So go ahead and that is it. And don't forget to leave your phone vertical and click that full screen, so don't turn it sideways, and enjoy the video. Hey everyone, this is Unlock24, and today I'm going to show you the level 30 farm deck that I've been using. Now, as you can see, I just farmed level 30 Bakura like an hour and a half or so ago, and I just switched back to Bakura and I had Taya equipped. Now, if you have Bakura, like if you've seen my previous video, you would not be able to, or the other Bakura would not be able to spawn in Duel World. Now, once he came up, I switched over to Bakura because I'm trying to farm his skills. I don't have all his skills yet, so I'm trying to farm him. And this particular one is a level 30, so I'm going to switch over to my level 30, I think is the one that says toy. Yeah, that one. And let's see if we can get him farmed. Now, let me show you so far what I've gotten from him. Let's see, your cards. This all I've received from him. I've gotten 3 Dark Botanas, one of the Trans Archfiend, a Torbus to the Forbidden Realms, just one, 2 Peking Goblins, 2 Dark Spirit of the Science, and then all those a ton of copies of those other common cards. So let's go ahead and get started with the farming. Now, I'll show you the farm deck here after we get done. But it's basically extremely simple to use. Let's see if it'll load up quickly. Jammy Bakura, level 30. And we're going second, that's fine. So the skill that we're using for farming is Earth, and what that does is it gets us a Leotor or a Huntsman. I'm with 7 weapons, so let's go ahead and summon this guy. And let's go ahead and suicide, because we really don't care, we want to thin our deck out. Hopefully he summons another 2,000 and that attacks us so we can do it. Another suicide maybe. It's a 13. Let's go ahead and allow that to go through. Alright, let's draw a card. Mirrorwall, that's fine. Let's summon this guy. And I always try to attack when I can, and I'm not sure if that's one of the reasons I've been getting more SR cards than most people. What was it? Is that a zombie? Yeah, I think it's a zombie. And let's set this card and go ahead and attack him. And end our turn. Now, eventually you'll need 2 union attacks for the final kill. Okay, summon this guy. He's probably going to flip it, or he didn't flip it. That's not a Leotor. Normal summon and then go ahead and attack. Okay. Hopefully we get an instant commutation here soon so we can get the Scorpion. Otherwise the Scorpion is not going to go up that high. Spiritualism. Okay, that's fine. An instant commutation or a Scorpion would be fine. Oh, there's a Scorpion. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and tribute for it. Yes, we'll tribute the... let's tribute that guy. Let's set our mirror wand. Hopefully he activates a Dark Door next turn. Because I do like to attack as many times as possible. And I'm not sure that if that's one of the reasons why I'm getting the more SR than most people are. Because I'm always attacking. And turn, activate Dark Door, please. No. I won't be able to attack unless I get a Huntsman. That's another insect imitation. Right, I'm gonna activate. I'm gonna tribute that and then get a. Now, the only reason I run that is because I don't have another insect. And I'm gonna bring it out in defense. That way, if there's some sort of point with the bot to where it says that I'm attacking with every attacking monster, That way it'll read it as I couldn't attack with that because it was in defense. I'm not sure if that's completely true or not. That's just how I've been doing it, and it's been successful most of the time, and I've been getting a lot of skills and red cards doing that. He hasn't activated the dark door. Hopefully he does here next turn. Another insect imitation. We're not gonna need that at all. I'm gonna keep the... Well, I should second summon it. So I'm on normal summon it, and then I won't be able to flip it to attack mode because it was just normal summoned. So I'm just gonna go ahead and attack with a scorpion again. Alright, let's pass our turn. Oh yeah, there's the dark door, and hopefully he summons a monster or sets. Oh, no set. Alright, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna summon the Karibo, and then I'm gonna attack him with it. And then I can't attack again because I've already attacked once. Okay, that's a Vassal. Then I'm gonna attack with Scorpion. I should have put the Karibo in defense. Okay. Let's go ahead and end our turn. Oh yeah, I do run one Blue Ice, and that's in order for us to make space for the Vassal, so then that's why I summon another Kariba, which it doesn't really matter. Otherwise, we wouldn't have enough space for to summon the Vassal. And hopefully I don't draw it at the very end. That's going to be kind of sad. And this is going to be a failure of a farm video. Alright, that's fine too. Okay. I'm going to change this to the fence. And I think I'm just going to end my turn since I don't want to go ahead and finish him off. And turn, I'm gonna send the insect imitations off. Alright, that's probably a nil blood. Summon, and there's a blue eyes. Alright, let's just go ahead and attack. Hopefully get another monster so we contribute it for the blue eyes. Okay, and we're gonna end our turn, and we're gonna send the other insect imitation because we don't need it anymore. No, not yet. Oh yeah, the reason I'm running the mirror walls is to bring down my life points down under 1,000. So as you can see, I currently have the 2,700 for now. I'm gonna attack with the scorpion again, and then next turn I'm gonna summon blue eyes. Okay. I'll go ahead and draw enemy controller. So my normal summon is tribute the Karibo, tribute the swordsman, set the enemy controller, and then attack with the scorpion. Hopefully he doesn't have another zombie, otherwise I'm gonna be out of luck. And I'm not gonna have that that assessment of yeah, he did have it. Of the cards on the brink, I think it's called. But we already have the over 9,000 damage in hand, so we can go ahead and perform it next, the turn after next. Let's see. So I do have to activate the mirror wall next turn, so. I'm going to try not to forget, cause sometimes I do forget and I don't activate it, and then I don't get the special assessment, so yes, activate it. Excuse me. Alright, so draw. So he doesn't have any more cards, so this is where we're going to go ahead and do the damage. So yes, pay for the 2,000, so now we're going to be at 700. Alright, so summon Gravekeeper's Vassal. Activate Union Attack. I'm going to activate both of them and equip or target the Vassal for both of them. And what this is going to do, it's going to activate at doing whenever we go into the battle phase. And then it's going to give the 6,000 and the 3,000 to the Vassal twice over. So let's go ahead and activate the stop defense. Target his monster. Okay. And now what I do is I go into the battle phase. And now the union attacks will activate. Now after they've activated, you can activate your enemy controller. And it won't change the attack on the Vassal. So tribute. And I'm going to tribute the blue eyes. And get his monster. And then attack for game. Okay, let's see. Hopefully we get an SR or something good. Or at least a skill. Alright, dual victory, low life points, few cards left, play prismatic card, play glossy cards, over 9999 damage, destroy 10 monsters, activate spell, activate travel, and perform special summon, perform tribute summon, so that's 74. And nothing good in this one, but you can see that you can get all the way up to 74, and in some cases you do get up to 8,000, just depending on what you destroy and how many monsters you destroy and all that. So that's basically it for on how to farm and the farm deck that I use for the level 30. It's actually extremely easy to use. However, some of the cards in it are actually kind of hard, or were kind of hard to get, and you can't get them anymore. Now, there's a ton of farming videos that you can look up on YouTube, and you should. There's a guy named Roshan or something like that, and Vodman X, you can check him out. He does a lot of farming videos as well. I don't really like to do farming videos. It's really not my thing. However, I do farm a ton, but the farming videos, in my opinion, they're extremely boring because you're just passing turn. So this is the deck I'm using. One Kaiser Seahorse, and I use that to tribute for the Blue Eyes. One Sphere Karibo, the Grass Chopper, and the Grass Chopper I only use to mill out my deck and get it to fewer cards with Insect Imitation, but it doesn't really have any point or anything, and it can just be used as a to get that extra tribute summon. The one Millennium Scorpion, and you only do need one. You don't need two or three or anything crazy like that. Three Leotaurs. The Leotaurs can actually be any level 4 Earth monster. I have three Leotaurs, so that's what I'm using. But if you don't have the three Leotaurs, you can just use any level 4 Earth monster that you have. It doesn't really matter. The Hunter with 7 weapons is the same thing. You can, to make it more consistent, you can switch out this two cards out with another two level 4 monsters, so you have something to tribute for Insect Imitation. And then of course you have the Gravekeeper Vassal, and then you run one Blue Eyes. I do run a prismatic that we got I think for free, and all of you should have a prismatic also for free. And then two Union Attacks. Now the Union Attacks is one of the cards that was extremely difficult to get, and if you didn't farm Yugioh, you probably do not have copies of those. And there's really no way to get him now. So that's the reason that a lot of people don't farm as good, because I don't have the Union Attacks, because the Union Attacks do help a ton, and they do help you get that 9999 damage. And so you, in this particular deck, you do need him. There is another version that I was using before I had the Union Attacks with Blue Eyes and the one of the ritual cards. I can't remember the name of it at the top of my head, but it's in my playlist. Just search for it and you'll be able to find it. So you do have to run one stop defense, and then the mirror walls are just there to bring your life points down. You don't need to have them, but if you don't have them, just use cards that that can increase your life points, so that way you, instead of going for the low damage, you go for the high life points, and most of the time it gets you most of the same assessment. So that's the deck I'm using. That's what I use mostly to farm, and that's how I play it. I know I try to attack every single time or as much as I can, even though, like, even if they're like low in life points or anything, I do try to attack as much as possible. And I'm not sure if that's one of the reasons I'm getting so many SR cards or whatever, but I am not cheating. I'm not doing any crazy stuff, and but I am doing a ton of farming, and this is how I do it. I'm not sure if there's greater drop rates with different decks, or if there's greater drop rates whenever you destroy more monsters or actually play the game or summon more monsters or anything like that. I don't have access to the code, so I can't really say for sure. And let's say, just in case, I play it in the way that if there is an increased drop rate, that's how I play it, and that's how I always try to play it. And most of the farm decks are just set and pass. I'm not really a big fan of it. They're extremely boring to me, and I do try to stay away. However, for the level 40 Bakura, you do have to play that style, because nothing else really works, and that Pinch Hopper does get you to where you need to go, and it does get you to that damage that you need, and it does stall out for all that. So that's what I'm using for the level 40 Bakura, and I do have a video of that in my playlist, so if you're interested in that, just go ahead and search for it. For today, this is going to be it. I won't have a video tomorrow. I'm going to be busy tomorrow, so I won't have a video uploaded tomorrow. So that's going to be it for today, and if you're enjoying my videos and anything, and if you have any comments or anything, leave them in the comment sections below. But that's going to be it for today, and I guess I'll see you guys on Monday.